Thunder. 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 Thunder by the power of Grayskull. When Ted says his secret magic word. Wait, no, that's not right. That's not right. It's Doctor Who. Did you miss me? Yeah, I bet you were all like, oh, what's going on? Where's Addie? I wonder if he's forgotten to make the stream go live again. I wonder if he screwed up. I wonder if, like, he, like, thinks he's live and he thinks that we can all hear him, but actually we can't all hear him, you know. But no, I was messing with your head. I'm in your head. Both of them. Both of them. Welcome to Doctor Who Legacy. Today we will have fun. Laughter, jollity, and chocolate. And a giveaway, and Susan, and I'm going to play this game, and loads and loads of things. Either way, I'm very, 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 very excited about all of the fun and excitement that we are going to have. Put your hands in, match up some gems, take your hands out, rearrange them again to make a better combination, activate an ability, and we're ready to go. Right, let's get Susan in on the stream. I'll get playing the game, and we'll get chatting about some good things and good times with the animals. Oh, good, I made Agri-Jagger-Jagger-Jagger jump. That's awesome.
Did I hear a promise of chocolate?
A promise of chocolate from me to me.
Oh. That doesn't really help me. What do you mean, oh? It doesn't really help me any.
Well, you go and get yourself some chocolate. We can all eat chocolate together.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If you haven't, if everyone watching, if you haven't yet retweeted the stream, please do so. I'm sure Susan has sent it out and I've sent it out. So if you wouldn't mind retweeting, that would be fantastic. Hey, Susan, thank you so much for joining us this evening.
My pleasure, as always.
I'm going to have a go at that new expert level. Mm-hmm. No, I'm not. That's a lie. I'm going to have a go at a really old expert level because that's as far as I've got. But it's still an expert level, so it still counts. Shush. But while I'm having a go at this really old expert level, which I am getting through, and I'm going to get them all
I'm
so I get my own
you.
Expert.
Really, you know, I cannot wait to put expert adipose in. And we're just waiting.
I can't
we're,
wait.
We're only waiting on you.
I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. So why don't, these are the new three
color,
ones, aren't they? They came out last night.
What color should expert adipose be, by the way?
Oh, can I get back to you? I will.
Okay, I'll let you design it. You get to pick the color and then the ability as long as it's reasonable.
Okay.
As long
okay.
as it's an
that's so, oh, that's so exciting. Oh, that's a lovely gift. Thank you. Thank you so much. Oh, now I've got like, the thing is they don't speak. So it has to be something from the Adipose episode. Okay. I'll get back to you on that one.
Squish.
So these are the new three. Squish. Yeah. Or these are the three new ones, aren't they? Why don't you tell us about them, and then when I'll,
yes,
once you start talking, I'll get started.
Expert levels. They are really, really hard. I got frustrated myself playing through them.
And you can't complete the third one until you've done the other two, because they're required characters. Is that
correct,
right?
Correct, yes. So the first level is called The Great Detective, and it actually requires the expert version of the 11th and the expert version of Strax. So you would have had to do those levels. Mm-hmm. First, to do the great.
Oh, hang on, Susan. I'm sorry to interrupt you, but something very important has just happened.
What?
I have been brought a chocolate bar. And
I like how you're seeming to grab it from like within Legacy. It's like so. It's like out of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
It's true. I'm grabbing it from the Legacy. Thank you, honey.
That's awesome. I can't reach my hand into the tablet and get a chocolate bar.
That's true. That'd be so cool. Match up three gems and like.
It's a fan
like,
area
be like,
perk. You can reach your hand
yeah.
into the tablet and get.
If you guys ever do a sequel, you could have like certain things that like pop out as you match up various things.
This looks awesome. And you just pulled coffee out. How did you do that?
I'm not entirely sure, but I did. I've shared my screen with you on Skype, by the way. So you should hopefully get a slightly more up to date screen if that's useful.
Yes, I do. I see it. I
So cool. So tell us more about these expert levels then. So Lee's had a field day making them very hard.
Yes. And so the Great Detective rewards you with Expert Vastra, who's a yellow ally. And then the second level is called Against the Clock. And it's not only is it expert, it's timed.
Oh, wow.
The reward is Expert Martha Jones, one of my favorites, who's green in expert version. Mm-hmm. And then once you do that, you can do expert, the final expert level, which is Pulse. And that requires the expert 10th Doctor and expert Martha. And then, so once you have her, once you've done Against the Clock, you can do the Bravest Human, which awards you with expert Mickey. Since they were married, you know, we thought it'd be kind of cute.
How is the alternative Mickey costume? The celebrity requested alternative Mickey costume coming along.
You know, I don't know if they've gotten started on that yet. We've got a lot like on the plate of pest right now. He finished up Tom Baker, the costume fund costume, which
we will be giving away later in this stream.
That's right, and he is working on stuff for Chapter 4. Which will be coming soon. So he's doing a lot of drawing there, and then alongside that, it doesn't really require his time so much. But alongside that, obviously we've got the bigger on the inside stuff coming, and the big finish stuff coming, and Titan stuff coming. There's lots coming.
It's awesome. There's so many cool little things coming out and already out. I mean, I was busy going through all the levels I still have to do, and I was like, "Oh my god,
it's a big game! It's a beefy game."
So it's sucking up all my iPad space. Yeah. I am out.
It's like the adipose of games. It's, you know, big and squishy. I don't mean you. You know, I mean the character. That pause there.
Right. Well, I'm going to open my chocolate. I'm going to have a sip of my chocolate in mock indignation. Now, for you guys later on, we've got that, as you should have seen for the newsletter, we've got that brand new Tom Baker costume, and the Doctor as well, if you haven't got him. And of course, we've got an Addy Gold giveaway later for a whole bunch of time crystals.
Pess did a great job, by the way. Did I send you the art? Do you have the art to put it on screen?
I saw it in the news. You may have sent me the art, but I saw it in the newsletter. Can I put it on the stream when I finish this level?
Yeah, and your coffee, yeah.
And hot chocolate, don't you know?
He did a great job. There were some people concerned that Tom Baker wasn't smiling again. We didn't actually pick the pose. Our players did. And it was voted on by Facebook. So if he's not smiling, then you only have yourself to blame.
It's your fault. Everything is your fault.
And actually, God, Tom Baker's smile is so hard to get right. As you may all recall from the very, very early stuff that we did for the Fourth Doctor, where he looked kind of like his face was made out of plastic or something.
Well, he's very much a kind of a character actor, and therefore to freeze him in one position.
Yeah, it's hard.
Is kind of part of the problem. Yeah. What the? Oh, I thought I just used my cure poison ability, but my cure poison ability seems to have just converted things to green. What? Did you change something in this expert level so that I can't cure the poison? Did you?
I don't know. You'd have to ask. We'd have to get Lee on the horn for that. I don't think so.
It's okay. I got an 8x combo anyway with blues and greens. This should be pretty awesome.
And
oh, that was pretty damn awesome. Oh, now I can't see a thing. But it was pretty damn awesome up until that point.
So speaking of expert levels, we also have we've had this like survey system going this week that I found, and I don't know if you saw, we've been letting the community design the next expert character, which was determined to be Rose Tyler.
Rose,
yeah,
yes.
not a vast surprise there. Rose Tyler, and red is the color, which does not seem to be the most popular decision among certain vocal members of the community. I think that black was perhaps something that we needed, but people chose red, and that's what happens when you open it up. So Rose is red, and right now on our website, we're designing the name for her ability. So if you haven't popped over there, you might want to, if you want to have your voice heard. Bad Wolf, unsurprisingly, seems to be the most popular contender right now.
What's the logic in team making? I know it was a vote, but what's the argument for making her red or making her not red?
There wasn't an argument. We opened it up to all five colors, and red was red one.
Okay,
that's it. That's all it was.
That's it.
Yeah. No, we didn't ask for anything to back it up, like, you know, red's my favorite color, or, you know.
Inside I have blood, which is red, so make her exactly. Red. Thank you. Thank you, Susan.
So that is done. And then, and then in the fan area, you might want to pop over there today because we have a new type of level, which is called target practice.
Oh, yes, I heard about this. Yes. So a level which I can never die on stream. Well, therefore, I'm always going to play it on stream.
Somebody apparently did manage to kill the enemy. So I think we're going to up the hit points in defense. It's some ridiculous stacky elements, apparently.
How long did they sit there and blow?
I don't know. Someone posted this morning that what does it mean if they actually killed the enemy? it means you get a cookie.
It means I have to fix the freaking level. That's what it means.
Someone on our subreddit community suggested it, and people, you know, liked the idea, and Lee liked the idea, as basically just a little sandbox level where you could go in and in sort of a very zen mode fashion, try different combinations of characters and see how they play without having to worry about dying or without having to, you know, necessarily, theoretically, kill the enemy, just as a messing around sort of level. So, sort of the next in like the sort of offbeat levels we've put in. You know, first it was Anna's Playground, which we're going to do follow-ups to, and then this is Sandbox level.
He's so almost dead. Come on, he's got to go. We got to take him down. We are going to take him down. But I know I really like this. Oh, he's so dead. I've got those kind of combos. He's very, very dead. Did Lee tell you about my super awesome idea for a Doctor Who Legacy survival level?
No, I don't think he did.
It's super awesome.
Is it like an endless corridor sort of thing?
And the expert level is... Oh, hang on. The expert level is not
there. Because we always talked about having an endless corridor, though. I don't know if our code currently supports like having procedurally generated, you know,
bad one.
On and on. There'd probably have to be an end. But
killed the big thing, but I didn't kill the little thing. I mean, who manages to do that?
I would like something like that, where you could just sort of compete to see how many levels you could get to.
The big one's freaking dead.
Having separate conversations, by the way.
Yeah, we're not going to. Well, I'm not. Yeah, because I'm concerned about this whole fact. Come on, die. There we go. That's better. Right.
Is that what you meant?
My idea. Well, I don't actually know what you mean by this corridor, but I get the idea of a procedurally generated level. My thoughts was because the other day I was when I, you know, we were doing all those streams the other day, and I was working on my combos and things like that. The idea was that I was trying to train myself to get at least a 4x combo every single time, right. which is definitely possible, but it's tricky, and there are times when it's really, really hard. And so then I actually thought this would be an interesting idea, that if you had a level where you had to get a certain number of combos each turn, otherwise you lose health, but you can't ever regain that health. And then, you know, and then the idea is basically you just keep going as far as you can. And if you wanted to have unlocks in it, it could be like if you managed to make it to say 50 turns, you get one unlock, and then 100 turns, you get another unlock. And then it could just be like a high score table. Because you know how people would go for it, you know, because it would be a challenge as well. Because, you know, there are some boards where it's just like, oh, yeah, 4x combo is easy. Or, you know, you'd have to think about exactly which number it would be or whether the number would increase. You know, for like the first 10 levels, it could be like a 1x combo or something. You know, I don't know. But I think the idea would be really fun. You know, that kind of tension of going, right, here's a board. I have to make this number of combos every time. It would be cool.
I like it.
And I've completed an expert level. That deserves added goal for everybody, completing an expert level, even if we're having two different conversations at the same time. So Lee can't join us today. What's up with the poor chap?
He's got a cold, flu-y sort of thing. You know.
Does it ever bother you marrying such a diseased man?
Yes. Our child is like a petri dish. He doesn't get sick.
That's awesome.
Yeah. He doesn't actually. Lee hardly ever gets sick. It's been a rough month.
Well, please pass on.
Oh, he's here in the channel. He's listening. And he said if need be, he'd pop in, but he's congested.
Can we get a mass get well soon, please, for Lee from all 344 of you, please? That would be pretty damn lovely.
Take some time off. We definitely could use some rest.
Right, I have today's team of the week is a little bit different, Susan.
Is it?
Because it's a mini team of the week, which means we're going to play the theme song. But what you need to mentally do, everyone who's watching, is every time it gets to, you know, team of the week, you need to imagine it's actually saying mini team of the week, mini team. Okay, so just mentally add the mini team bit, and then I'll tell you why after I've played an awesome. Oh, look at all those get well soons. Aww. Oh, that's very, very cool. Aww. I might even fake a disease next week just so I get one.
Oh, that's very sweet. Thanks, guys.
That is very sweet. Cool. Right. Mini team of the week. Here's the song. Sing along. You gotta try the team of the week. Team of the week. If you're out of luck and your strategy sucks and there's something new you seek, try the team of the week. Yeah, the team of the week. Try the team of the week, people. It'll make you feel good inside. Yeah, try the mini team of the week, people. It'll make you feel good inside. Right, well, here is this week's mini team of the week. Let me explain the logic behind this one. So obviously you guys know that I've been trying to catch up with all the things I've missed in terms of, you know, I've been holding myself back and holding myself back, and then it's just got to the ridiculous point that I'm now ridiculously behind. So we're going for it. I'm going to catch up with everything. So I've been reading the forums, I've been looking on the wiki, I've been, you know, getting myself back into the hub of it. And it turns out, as I'm sure loads of you are completely aware of this already, that loads of you do Jenny whenever you want to upgrade your characters. And in the fan area, and obviously if you haven't got the fan area yet, go get it. There is a really short, decent, mid-range level called Jenny. And if you do Jenny over and over, it's a really, really good way of leveling up your characters. Now, to be able to do Jenny quickly, what you need is a few little stud muffins to carry you through the level really quickly. And then with those stud muffins, you can just chuck in a few other people, and those will be the people that will kind of be upgraded and level up as you go. Now, of course, there may well be other levels that do this, and it'll be great to get some more suggestions, you know, in the chat from other levels where you can upgrade. But by grinding Jenny repeatedly, you can end up with quite a lot of results. Very, very.
This sounds like a lot of double entendre. It's just me.
I'm going for as many as I can while keeping a straight face. Thank you for appreciating.
Just to be clear.
Yeah. I mean, if you want to join in with any point, that's fine. So the mini team of the week is, and there are lots of variations that would work here, but I'll explain the logic behind mine. The mini team of the week is the Sixth Doctor, Orson, and Vastra, and I've got them all at level 50 because the idea is that they're all yellow, which means that none of them are weak to the enemies that are there, and they're strong against the black one, and so by themselves they can actually complete this level very, very, very quickly, because the idea is to get in and out of Jenny as quickly as possible so we can do it repeat. You made me laugh. I was doing well. That was your fault. I'd written all these down before the stream as well. I wasn't going to laugh.
There's no way you're coming up with this on the fly.
Well, I've been known to dabble with an improvisation. So here you go. You need to go into the fan area. Now, let's do the little plug while we're going into the fan area. Susan, why the hell should I go into the fan area?
Well, the biggest reason for you guys as players is because there's so much free stuff in there. All the characters and costumes in the fan area drop the first time you finish a level, so you don't have to worry about grinding for rare drops. Grinding Jenny, for instance, for rare drops. And the other big reason is because that's what helps us afford to keep making this game. We are probably the most ambitious mobile game, I would say, on the market where it comes to continuing to support a free game with new stuff all the time. And I won't lie, it's expensive. And so when you guys spend money on fan area and time crystals and stuff, we never force you to, but when you do, you're helping us to help you and make more stuff.
Indeed. And there is so much cool stuff in here. So it is absolutely, it's worth your money from a point of view of supporting the game that you love, but it's also worth your money because you get so much cool stuff. So here is good old little Jenny. So I know a lot of you have been grinding Jenny for, you know, for a long time now, but we're just going to come in. And so as you can see on the right hand side, I've got the three characters that I'm going to level up. And on the left hand side, I've got my mini team of the week. And you go in and it's a one wave level that will give us about 22,000, 23,000 XP. I believe it used to give more, but that was back before, you know, that was when, like, you know, Susan was a little bit less grumpy, but now it gives less, but that's fine because it's still,
there was a period of time where we left the bonus experience on the fan area for an extended period without my knowledge.
You forgot to take it off, didn't you?
Our tech team did. I'm going to totally blame it on them.
Yeah.
So
it's a one wave level. This is it. So it's one red enemy, one black enemy, one blue enemy. So the reason why I've gone for a yellow team is because they're strong against the black, And they're not weak against the other two. And then, so what you're really looking forward, and I've set my perks up to be positive yellow. And then in theory, as long as we get a 5x combo, we're guaranteed to do it in one turn. And if we don't, we should still manage to do it, in two really. So I'm just going to link it all up like that. Give myself a nice 6. I'll put the greens like that in case we get another green. We should get at least a 2x combo, 3x combo. Got the technical as well. The whole lot goes off and boom. The whole lot goes down. Single turn, victory. Very, very excited. And then watch this. These level one characters are going to go.
And we to interject, we're going to be doing some more of those week-long experience and time fragment drop rate and stuff promos again starting next week. The plan right now is that next, obviously Wednesday night is now the return to weekly patches. So Wednesday night, Pacific time, Thursday early morning for Brits. So last night, that was the new expert levels and the new fan level. Next week, we'll start those week-long promos again. So next Wednesday night, we'll start 150% time fragment drop rate in the fan area. And the following week, 150% experience in the fan area. And then we've got some other non-fan area stuff as well coming, like dropping the price of random rolls for a week and experience in non-fan area chapter levels and stuff. But those are the first two, just as another thank you to people who've unlocked the fan area.
Will that sounds awesome. Will all that stuff be in the newsletter for us to
kind of remind? Exactly.
There's quite a lot of different things.
Yes, great. There's a lot of stuff.
Does the fan area still have, just because I know it used to, a higher...
It does.
Fragment drop
rate.
It does
across the board. Time fragments drop in the fan area levels more often. So if you're trying to grind,
so as well as grinding Jenny, if you're looking to get fragments, you can. That is the best place to come, and you can see how effective that's been. You know, I've got those three at the bottom are now Vincent's level 7, almost level 8. Amy's level 7, almost level 8, and Clara, the expert Clara, is now 8, which also actually proves the experiment we were doing the other day with you know, that different characters level up at different rates. But there you go. So if I do that again, then they'll actually all be at level 10 and ready for me to use fragments to kind of level them through. But there you go. That is today's mini team of the week. So I'll just do that one more time. Then we'll go to commercial. And when we come back, oh, look at that. It's got a five waiting for me already. So we'll just put those greens together and stop there. Is that going to be enough? That might be enough to take it down. Let's find out. If not, it'll just take me an extra turn. Nope, that's it. Boom! Headshot.
Boom.
Mini team of the week. And that should take all three of those all the way to level 10. Obviously, the more you level up your characters, the longer they take to level up each time because the gaps get bigger. But the principle's pretty sound. All right. We're going to go to commercial. When we come back, giveaways, fun, jollity, laughter. And me in these headphones. See you in a sec. therefore we've done it.
Yeah, that's what I was looking for. Okay.
Mini team of the week, welcome back. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is The Adipose, and I'm here with Susan, the senior creative director.
That's Lee.
Principally of Doctor Who Legacy, and I am the superficial streamer. Yes. Official title. We all promoted ourselves the other day. If you missed it, you missed out. And I'm going to show you our very cool little Tom Baker, if I can find a way of downloading it.
Did I just send that to you?
You sent it to me through Skype, and now I don't know how to grab it.
Right click.
Jump back, copy message.
I'll email it to you as well.
Yeah, email it to me, please. Thank you. So this is the new Tom Baker, which we're gonna show you. You've probably seen it in the newsletter. So to clarify this one, Susan, so this was one of those fan funded ones.
It was,
is that right?
Yes, it was the second of them. Took a little bit longer than we expected, just because Tom Baker always seems to. Everyone's very picky on him, which is good. We should be.
He's when people think Doctor Who, he's one of probably the first two faces that people think of. So
there are a few of them that we try hard on all of them, but there are a few of them that I'd say get more scrutiny than anything else, and Tom Baker is certainly one of them. So
let's put that bad boy up on the screen. Not that I often get to call Tom Baker a bad boy, but let's hope he doesn't watch this, otherwise I'm going to be very embarrassed. There we go. Meet a file. There we go. Fourth Doctor. There it is. I'll make it nice and big. It is a pensive pose, but it's definitely him. And the costume is beautiful. It's like a kind of like a, I've just destroyed a load of bad guys, but I had to take out three solar systems to do it.
Looks very warm, doesn't he?
He does look incredibly warm. He looks very, very skinny, but very.
How much more clothing could you possibly wear?
Very, very warm. Yeah, he's like tripled his body size. Exactly. He also has the world's longest neck there as well. But it's a great picture, and you've got the
I mean, it's definitely
it is. I'm gonna have to get me one of those.
He does look sad, but you know it's right before he regenerated. So,
oh, is it?
Yeah, he wore that in the episode before he turned into Peter Davison.
Oh, when he had the monk following him around, the ghost following. What do they call it? There was something following him. They called it. That's gonna annoy me.
Yeah, I don't remember.
He was like being stalked by a ghost for like the last series, but it had a name. But it's a very good costume. What do we think, guys? Do we like that? It is, and we're going to be giving you the code for that right now. Now, what we've decided to do, this is an experiment. If it works, hooray! If it doesn't work, then damn it, we'll try exactly this. It's my fault because it was actually my suggestion. Obviously, we've been having issues with people giving out the codes we're not supposed to. So instead. Rather than us kind of having a big fuss every week and then it may be going right and maybe going wrong, instead what we're going to do is we're going to just stick a time limit on the code. And so the code is going to expire at the end of the stream. Now, we still don't want you to spread it out, so please don't tweet it out. Please don't do that kind of stuff. But we're going to care a lot less because actually, if it is shared out, it's not going to work anymore. So it's going to stop working right at the end of this stream. So the idea is that it's for you guys that are right here, right now, for you to enjoy. Please enjoy, you know, get your little Tom Baker, run around from the rooftops, you know, open up the windows of the house and go, I got Tom Baker in the red costume and stuff like that. But it's just for you. So, and in theory, because it is going to expire, it means if you're not here, you miss out. So, you know, if there are people that kind of say, hey, I didn't get it, tell them, well, you should have been here. Addie was here. Susan was here. They made some obscene jokes about Jenny. And then, you know, maybe they'll come along next time, you know.
And we will find you because, you know, Cherie in particular is awesome at finding people who share codes.
You see, I was being all nice.
You'll be shamed.
See, I was doing the whole nice thing about how it doesn't matter anymore about, you know, because the code is, yes, you know, going to time out. And then you went whole, like, Liam Neeson taking, you know, I don't know who you are.
Like the scarlet letter A. We're going to put, like, a scarlet letter C.
Just drop it. Drop it, Susan, okay? Drop it. Move on from the code sharing thing. Okay, here we go. Get your lovely Tom Baker, which I'm also going to put into my little one as well. In theory, this should work. It's 7, 8, 4, 3, 4, 5, 3, sorry, I forgot how to read numbers, 5, 2, and 3, 9, 6, 4. And if you hit claim code, as I'm currently doing on the screen right now, there's an awkward pause.
And enter it now,
found
guys.
New outfit.
Guys, don't wait. Enter it now. I know I would say yeah. people don't, but go enter it. It really is going to expire in about 26 minutes.
Yeah, exactly. So and I think this makes it easy. So right now, you know, we'll make sure we don't mention anything really important in the next 2 minutes.
Yeah.
You know, load up your game, put the code into the game, and come back. All I'm going to be doing for the next couple of minutes is eating chocolate in front of Susan until she gets really cross.
I was thinking about explaining the meaning of life, but I guess I'll stop.
Well, yeah, no, you go for that while I eat chocolate. So, you know, go and put it into your game right now. And then you, too, will have a very, very cool code. In fact, I will go and, as I have found the costume, I should go and check it out right now.
You should do a commercial break during this. That would have been the perfect time to do commercial breaks.
That would have been the perfect time to do the commercial break, except I didn't. So thank you. But no, good plan. See, we're all learning together.
Yes,
we're all learning together.
Yes.
So Doctor.
Nice, Henmore. And Morris says you've posted a credit card number on screen.
It's not my fault that his credit card number happens to be the same as a Doctor Who legacy card. Well, in that case, if it is Henwar's credit card number, then once again, you've only got until the end of the stream to literally cash that in. Yeah. So there you are. And there is the new costume. It's quite scary having the little mirror image there of the two of them on the stream together. And a very, very cool looking costume it is. So obviously when we put him in a team... let's see how that looks when we get a nice little close-up of him. Do I have any Fourth Doctor teams ready to go? I think I swapped that out earlier, actually. There we go. That's how it looks when you get just the headshot.
But we actually are working on an expert mode version of the Fourth Doctor that we have some new ideas for that we're batting around. So he definitely
fantastic.
Is in the works.
I'm going to ask a question, which is obviously going to upset you because everyone asks it. But are you ever tempted to put in the... 50th anniversary Fourth Doctor?
The curator. People definitely ask about it, but no one really, I think, quite knows what to do with that.
I think you need to say who knows and stroke your face.
Yeah, yeah.
Because is he a doctor? Is he not a doctor? I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. It's quite cool. Was it just supposed to be, you know, is it just, you know, Tom Baker playing a different character that's supposed to be unrelated? Or I don't think there's enough information to go on.
Yeah, you might even have to put him as a separate... Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. I know exactly what you mean.
You could also just consider it a cameo, right? That it was just him being somebody else.
I'm certain it was intended to be as a, you know, just a lovely thing for the fans to have. However, he was in the show and it would be although, you know, good luck getting an old version of Tom Baker through the...
maybe an ally. That's a good point that someone just said, as opposed to a doctor.
Yeah, I mean, should be vague. Although, you know, that you might have interesting ones if you ask Pete about that and, you know, go, well, you see, it's a doctor. Scrape, 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 scrape. Oh, but he's not a doctor. Scrape, 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 scrape.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I don't remember there being any evidence that he had, like, sort of the abilities of a Time Lord any more than, like, the Metacrisis 10th does, right?
Other than...
Did he? I'm sorry, it's been a while.
Knowledge. He was clearly very knowledgeable and... Yeah, well, you could talk for an hour about that.
But
it's an interesting one, right, guys? I'm going to completely blank the question board. If you've got any questions for Susan, then use exclamation mark question. I'm going to open the Addy Gold giveaway in about 5 minutes, and I'm going to take the code off the board in probably like one or two as well. So get that in there right now, because remember, it is going to expire. While people are getting their questions in, Susan, what else? Have you got any other things in your little list that you'd like to talk about or announce today?
Well, next week's Twitch and the two after that are all going to be at an hour later than they normally are.
I see.
Yes, right? So that'll be 1 o'clock Pacific time, 9 o'clock UK time. And
that's my fault, everyone. Sorry, it's a work thing. It's pushing us back a little bit. So for 3 weeks, we'll be an hour later. Sorry in advance if that affects anyone, but I will make sure the shows are all up on YouTube after the day. If that means anyone can't watch it, it will mean... I'll make sure they're up on YouTube so you can catch them later. But don't forget, 1 hour later next week.
Now, for next week's, we actually have a special guest, which is Andrew James from Titan Comics. We are tentatively planning, if we get everything we need in time, to have a few new Titan Comics levels coming this coming week. So basically the next patch. And it'll be one for the 10th, one for the 11th, one for the 12th. And it's new costumes for each of the 10th, 11th, and 12th Doctors that were drawn by Titan. They look really, really cool. A little bit like portrait costume series, but different. A little bit, comic-y. But different, yes. So that's coming. And I think, if I remember correctly, yeah, we're also going to try next week to get a new level into the fan area, which would reward you with Arc from Titan Comics, which I know a lot of people have been asking for. So we're also trying to get that live for next week. And then we have new challenge levels in the works that Lee is working on. That'll be coming the following week. We have a new client update, which we've been promising, you know, with the one turn buff and stuff. We had some issues with, some buggy software, that we use third party stuff that we're waiting for them to fix so that we can push the new update live. Oh, and I think, I guess this was since I was last on here, that Amazon's new, has a client update. If anyone's on Kindle and hasn't grabbed the new update on the Amazon store, you should, because that can affect like claiming promo codes and stuff if you don't. So grab that. And the new thing is that if you're on BlackBerry, which we don't mention too much, and or Android non-Kindle devices, you can also get that now on the Amazon store. They asked us to start supporting other stuff. And so what that means is that you could theoretically cloud save between like a BlackBerry device and an Amazon – or and BlackBerry, Android, and Kindle. If you were doing it through the Amazon store. And at the end of this month, we are going to be free app of the day on Amazon for like 4 days. And there's going to be a special reward for new players as well. So that's coming.
And you know, your app is a free app.
It is, but they it's going to have like value added stuff, you know, some doctors, some characters, stuff like that for new players.
Extra free.
Yeah. Extra free. Free plus plus. Yeah.
Cool. That's major. Yeah, So on the Google store, did you say?
This is on the Amazon store. The Amazon store supports BlackBerry and supports non-Kindle Android devices. And we still have the Windows thing in the works. I know people have been asking. It's more complicated than we thought it was, surprisingly, to get onto Windows. It's becoming more of a chore than we thought it was. So we're still hoping, but it's not.
Well, it's on Facebook. I mean, obviously, it's nice to be on as many things as possible, but if it is on Facebook, then it is on Windows, isn't
it? Yeah.
But maybe I'm oversimplifying and I'm missing something.
Some people want to play it on their Windows phones, you know, things like that.
Or don't want to play on Facebook
and just want to play it like in their IE browser, stuff like that. So we're trying.
I am actually going to get myself a new phone at some point in the next couple of weeks, and then I can start joining in conversations like, you know, Windows phone, Android phone, iOS phone.
Are you getting an iOS phone?
Know what people talk about. Well, this is the thing. I obviously, being a streamer, I need to have as many kind of access to as many kind of gamey things as possible. So I've got an iOS iPad,
yeah,
obviously. So it probably makes sense to go for an Android phone, although I do really like Apple stuff. So
I love both. I love my Android devices, and I love my iPad mini too. So there's some great Android devices out now.
Yeah, I was looking at one called the HTC One or something.
Yeah, and it's very inexpensive over there too, as I recall, right? I think that's what Lee and I use when we're in the UK, is an HTC.
So I think that might be the one I go for, but I'd be open to suggestions from people.
Yeah.
Right, let's get our Addy Gold giveaway going while we get chatting. So tonight's giveaway is a Time Crystal giveaway. And we've got, if I'm remembering correctly from Susan, 2 packs of 6 crystals. Is that right?
It is, correct.
So as you guys, I'm sure you know, Time Crystals are the premium currency of Doctor Who Legacy. You can carry on levels when you muck them up. You can unlock characters. You can unlock costumes. You can do the random the random thing where you get roll for random characters and random things. What else am I missing? What else can you use Time Crystals for? You can upgrade
perks.
Characters if you upgrade. Oh, and perks. Yes, loads and loads and loads and loads of stuff. So a very useful little utility prize for you. And of course, this is an Addy Gold giveaway. So check your gold using !! Addy Gold. I'm going to start the raffle. We'll have 2 winners this evening. And obviously, the more tickets you buy, the more chance of your name being called. And that is going to be running for about the next 8 minutes, because Susan has to depart quickly at 9. Otherwise, she turns into a pumpkin.
I do. How did you know that?
It was all the seeds on the floor.
Gotcha.
Plus, you keep singing the Ippity Bobbity Boo song. I keep nearly dying. I do really keep nearly dying on this level. It's like my new thing of death. Stop dying, Addy. So this is I finally completed. I got very excited. It was after you left, actually, on the other day. No, skip that. It was last night. I completed season 3, or whatever you're calling it these days, chapter 72, whatever it is. So I'm now getting to the properly hard stuff, and I'm fully, you know, those who are about to die salute you and all that kind of stuff, because it's these guys are kicking my ass at the moment. Come on, heal. Oh, I forgot to match the pinks. No, I do. He's dead. Can I ask you some questions, or do you have
you
more to
say? You can absolutely ask me questions,
say?
No.
Okay, are there any plans for a 10th anniversary level or drop? Good question.
Yes, we'd like to do, we know what's coming. We'd like to do stuff for it. We're not ready to say, you know, to expand on that yet.
Okay, cool. So good stuff coming. I'm going to take it off the screen now. So this is your last chance to claim it, because it will stop working at the end of the stream. If you want the Tom Baker costume, which is currently on the screen, it's 7862-8434-5352-3964. And because I am going to take it off the screen, I will just paste it once into the chat as well. But that will stop working, so go grab it. And now I'm taking it off the screen. At least I thought I was taking it off the screen. There we go. And I'm going to move Tom out of the way. There you go. Tom can go on top of the master there in a game of awkward.
By the way, I was disappointed not to see more caught playing Doctor.
I'm sorry, I completely misheard something very obscene there. So could you say that again?
Do you remember last time we were on, when I popped on to talk to you, we discussed pictures caught playing Doctor.
Yes!
Yeah, I only saw two of them. There were two very, very cool ones online, but I only saw two.
Oh, I only saw one. Oh, you one up on me. Yeah. Guys, we want this. We think this is hilarious. I think this is hilarious. And if I think it's hilarious, that's all that counts. We want to get a picture of yourself playing Doctor Who Legacy, but like surprised, as if you've been caught playing it, you know. Put yourself somewhere amusing, you know, on the crapper, in the shower, on a ski lift, in the TARDIS, at work, in bed, under a table. You know, put yourself somewhere entertaining, playing Doctor Who Legacy. Put a big shocked look on your face.
Exactly.
Like, and, you know, hashtag caught playing. What is
caught playing Doctor? Caught playing the Doctor?
Caught playing Doctor or caught playing Doctor Who Legacy? We should pick one. Caught playing Doctor. Caught playing Doctors. There you go. Hashtag caught playing Doctor. You know, give us some cool stuff. I'll retweet you. Susan will retweet you, as long as it's not too obscene.
Absolutely, yes.
And it'll be fun. Although I haven't done mine yet. But I think I know some people will go, cool, I'll take a photo of myself with my foot. Oh, I can't. So, playing Doctor. So, you know, a little bit of ingenuity will be required.
Website. Maybe I'll have a page devoted to caught playing Doctor.
That would be cool.
That be cool.
A special page.
Enough of them, totally. If you guys like rise to the challenge and do it.
That would be cool. Yeah. That would be very, very cool. So let me crack on with this. will gadgets ever become companions, e.g. a sonic screwdriver? I know in the past you've vaguely said things like, oh, we might have other plans for accessories, but that was a long time ago, I think you said things like that. So is there a current plan?
For you mean like t-shirts and stuff?
No, I think... No, the question is, will gadgets ever become companions, like the sonic screwdriver?
Oh, you know, we've talked about stuff off and on with that. I don't see it happening in Legacy. You know, Torchwood, it might be somewhere where we start doing gadgets, I think we've talked about. But I don't think...
Oh, yeah, because the whole show in Torchwood is a bit more gadgety-oriented.
Yeah,
have the sonic in the swimming.
It's a big game, and every time we layer in new stuff like that, it gets even bigger. And so I think that would probably be something for a follow-up as opposed to within this game itself.
I'm having some chocolate, so I can't actually respond to what you said, but that was a good answer.
Thank you.
Cola 96 says, mm-hmm. Just lost it. Cola 96 says, are experience points split between the allies, or does each character get that many experience points? This is obviously a question about leveling them up. I believe all characters on a team get exactly the same experience points regardless of their contribution. Is that right?
I believe that's true, yes.
Some more requests for costumes for other classic Doctors. So you've mentioned that the comic strip is going to give us some more costumes for 10th, 11th and 12th. Mm-hmm. Any plans in the works for more classic Doctor costumes?
More classic Doctors or more classic Doctor costumes?
More classic Doctor Who costumes.
So you mean, well, we don't have that many classic characters yet. You mean like Ace and...
No, like the classic Doctors.
Yes.
Like, so you've just done the Tom Baker.
Costumes for them. Yes, yes, of course. I mean, you know, it's one.
Shall I write my questions down in advance and message them?
Sorry, what the heck are you saying?
To you.
Yes, yes, of course. We definitely have some doctors who've been underrepresented where it comes to costumes. Peter Davis comes
cool.
to mind. And I see other people asking about Classic Who companions. And yes, definitely. I have seen the script for Chapter 4, and there are definitely some more classics coming, I promise.
Real Tegan, otherwise known as the Taganator, asks, are you aware that putting in blank companion pictures makes the anally retentive fans go insane wondering who and what they are?
Yes, the problem is when we put characters in, they automatically get added to that total. And right now there is a character sitting in the database that has not gone live. It's because they're waiting on approval. No, it's not Donna Noble, so no conspiracy theories. There's just a character sitting in there, and that is the reason why nobody can max out their companions right now. That's the answer.
Oh, man. All of those OCDs all over the world going crazy because of what you've done.
Hilarious. I get it. I have OCD myself. But yes, there is a companion which it is impossible for you to get. So just pretend it's Max.
How is the Torchwood game coming, by the way? You mentioned it a second ago, and obviously
things are continuing to move ahead promisingly. It's a big undertaking for us, so we're being cautious and making sure that everyone that we need is on board, and it is moving in the right direction, I'll say, and we're really excited about it too. I love Torchwood.
Cool. For those of us that are legacy fans, just to reassure people, Legacy still staying as it is.
Absolutely.
Still
this is,
being
this
released,
be a
still being supported.
Sort of add-on team, within Seed that would be doing Torchwood. So, I mean, obviously, it'll share the same code base. It'll be inspired by, but heavily the next generation of it. So, improve user interface and unique new stuff. So, but it will not impact us supporting Legacy in any way. If anything, it's a good thing for Legacy.
And just to give more work for poor Pest, the Labradorite asks, are we ever going to get portrait costumes for 4 and 5? Because I know he originally did them almost as like a little side hobby, didn't he?
Exactly, yeah. And the 12th, for that matter. It's not even just the 4th and the 5th. Yes, at some point. But there are bigger fish to fry first with Chapter 4.
Cool. Right, well, let's get this. So I'm going to close the added gold giveaway in about 2 minutes time. Okay, so this is your last chance to win 6 time crystals, 2 winners, and of course you enter using the normal exclamation mark raffle ticket and then the number of tickets you want. The more tickets you buy, the more chance you have of winning, and we have got 22,613 tickets in there already. Woo! They want your crystals, Susan.
How many was that? I missed that.
22,613. Nice. Awesome. Azaloth says, Susan, what is your favorite chocolate?
Ooh, anything dark.
Clary likes the dark stuff.
I hate white chocolate. It's not actually chocolate. And
take that back. Take that back. Milky Way bars. Milky bars.
White chocolate is not even chocolate. No. It's carob.
No.
Whatever the hell that is.
Well, isn't it like a little beetle from in Egypt?
Basically, so you're eating beetle.
Well, it's very nice.
There
beetle.
Is very little. Like, I'm one of those people who will pretty much eat anything, almost without exception, and I hate white chocolate.
But not skiing. Okay. Here's an interesting one. Slovakian Who. What was the main reason to start Doctor Who Legacy?
Wow.
You're not allowed to say money and greed.
That's exactly what it is. We've talked about this extensively and probably answered it better than I can right now in the limited time left. But a few big things. Probably the biggest one was Lee and I wanting to take on a project that we felt we could handle on a publishing side, just the two of us, and then bring in Seed as partners to help on the tech and the art and so forth. So something that was manageable, something that was data driven, where we could keep making new stuff over a period of time. It's one of our favorite shows, so that was really exciting to us when it came to us as an opportunity. And we love puzzle games. We've worked on puzzle games before, and are a big fan of the genre. And so the idea of marrying Doctor Who with puzzle gaming. And sort of just trying to change the tone of free-to-play gaming and how publishers treat their players in free-to-play gaming. All those things together sort of came together, and that's why Legacy happened.
And the perfect storm created.
But legacy. I think I've answered that far more elegantly in interviews where I've had time to actually think that through and type it.
No. That was a good. That was a,
it's a lot of stuff. You know, Lee and I have been making games for like over 18 years now. And
you were part of the original Pong team, weren't
yes,
you?
Yes. No. But, you know, we've worked on some massive, massive projects, you know, Grand Theft Auto and BioShock and Borderlands and stuff like that. This is the most fun we've ever had on any of the games we've worked on. You know, I get up in the morning looking forward to hearing what people have to say and what's happening next and hearing what we can do next. And that's really fun. Really, really fun. Special. I hope we can keep going for a long time. If for no other reason, then I really enjoy supporting it.
Right, let's get this giveaway done. We're gonna go for our final commercial, and when we come back, I shall draw the winners, and I'll put your final questions decision, and of course, we'll have our final little plug that we'd like to have. So we will see you in 60. Don't go anywhere. Hello, I'm back. I'm kicking these little robots' butts, but we've got more important things on the line because we need to close the raffle. Final total, 24,228 tickets. We'll start the tombola, and we can call it the tombola because Lee isn't here and he won't object. But nevertheless, the tombola is what it is. And good luck to everybody. So we're going to have two winners, and Susan will message you your code, which will give you 6-time crystal via Twitch direct message straight away. So go and check them. Good luck to everybody. If you don't win, my commiserations. But don't worry, come and see some streams and get some more added gold, and you can try again next week. Speaking of coming to see some more streams, me and Clary and you, the viewers, have restarted our Doctor Who review shows. Obviously, there's no Doctor Who at the moment, so we're doing series 3. We did The Runaway Bride on Sunday night. So Sunday night, not Saturday night. And so this week we're going to be doing Smith and Jones. So why not watch Smith and Jones before Sunday and come along and join the fun. Tell us what you think. Good things, bad things, funny things. It's always fun for a giggle. Be great to see you there. Our first winner is...
Oh, yeah!
Vertigoer. Congratulations, Vertigoer. I have to remind... all of you, of course, bot will only pick you if you are following the channel. So make sure you have hit that follow button, because this is a giveaway to promote Doctor Who Legacy, to promote me, and to promote peace on Earth. And our second and final winner today, good luck everybody, is
oh yeah,
the Doctor's Companion 39. And I'd forgotten that I'd put the oh yeahs back in. That is awesome. I love the oh yeahs. Oh yeah! Congratulations, Doctor's Companion 39, which is very cool. Your codes will be coming to you. Susan, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
For joining us.
I see some playing Doctor stuff coming up on Twitter, by the way.
Oh, awesome. Yeah. Cool. I will go and check them. I'll finish this level and I'll go. I'll stay on for a little bit after you go.
And
also,
someone informed me that the chocolate is not carob. It's actually the oil from the chocolate, with all the chocolate removed. How disgusting is that?
I was fairly sure that you were wrong, but I didn't want to say anything because, you know, like, you know, it's on stream. It would be awkward. You could be I hear this other guy's got a live stream. Maybe we'll get him doing like shit. I'm sorry, Shine. It's caribou or whatever it was you said it was. Yeah, sure. White chocolate caribou. Why not? There we go. Do you want to plug your shiz? Go for it. Sell it to me,
Susan. How many tickets do those people spend? Don't we usually say?
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. Vertigoer spent $500. Wow, that's a big load. And Doctor's Companion $39. So the Doctor's Companion $39.
Oh, you got off easy.
Ooh, $149.
There we go.
$149.
Okay. Go. Joseph Vincent, plug DoctorWhoLegacyGame.com. Make sure you grab the patch. Review us on the stores if you haven't. Unlock the fan area if you haven't. Loads of more reasons coming over the coming couple weeks with bonus experience and bonus time fragments and arc. So if someone in this channel has actually not unlocked the fan area, I hope you think about doing it today. That's it.
Please do. And I, as always, will be streaming throughout the week, doing a lot more Legacy than usual at the moment, obviously, because I'm getting through the stuff. So, you know, pop on, follow me on the channel, check your emails, check your Twitters. You may see me doing that. You will probably also see me doing an Infamous playthrough at the moment, the occasional bit of Hearthstone, maybe some Don't Starve, maybe some Magicite, maybe some... I can't remember what stuff I'm playing at the moment. Stuff. Playing with people. So come join the fun at any time. There's always people in here having a good chat. Well, we'll say goodbye to Susan here, and then I'll pop onto the Twitter and we'll see what I can see with Corp playing Legacy. Thank you, Susan. It's been great having you on as usual.
And it was great being here.
And that code expires
now.
Right now. Right now. So if you didn't put it in, allow me to be the first to say,
don't email me at support, because I'm just gonna shame you. No, I wouldn't do that.
You missed it. But if you were here and you enjoyed the stream and you got your code, congratulations. Go play with your doctor who's unnecessarily long scarf. Thank you for joining us, Susan. It's been great having you here.
Thank you.
Take care. Bye-bye. Right, Corp playing Legacy. Let's go and find out. I may have died on that level because I wasn't concentrating right at the end. And I could have healed. We all know I could have healed. Damn it, now I want to do that level. I'm going to do that freaking level. Gonna do that freaking level because I shouldn't have died on it. I lost focus. There was two turns in a row where I got two combos. Who does two combos? Why does everywhere seem so bright when we leave the TARDIS? That's it. That was the whole thing. Great. There we go. We get one of them. We get one of them. We get one of them. We turn it into a five. Put the pinks there as well. Huzzah! Hurrah! Four times. Five times. Six times. Attack. Boom. Let's put some greens together. Let's go down the side. Let's put some blues together too, and then we'll go along for the ride. Let's go black time. Five combo. Six time. Ten cold. Yeah. Bring it on. Die, army robot. Die. Ow, that hurt me. You hurt me with your lasers and your face. I need to match up the pinks, if nothing else. So I could grab the black. I could grab the red. Let's go around the world a little bit. Think I'm going to end up with a black here. But it's not a bad start. We've got the four in a row. Got the yellows there as well. Don't think we're going to get the blacks, but still four, five, six if we're lucky. There we go. Very nice. Attack. Attack. Don't die. Right, good, good, good. Right, let's see if we can find another little combo. We've got the greens and we've got the yellows at the bottom. But you might need to double loop to get them. But if we do a double loop, we get stuck, and I don't like getting stuck. So if we do it vertically instead on the right-hand side at the bottom, we could put in a green combo, black combo, come up to the top, go for a blue combo two, and then I can finish off the black T. Five combo, which gives us the bonus there as well. Boom! Headshot. Although we are now getting hit, so we need to heal up. Have I got any abilities yet? No. Whoopsie! So. Let's go for this one, this one, this one. Oh, crap. Then I've cocked up the whole pink things. Ah, no. Heal. Oh, I forgot to heal. Oh, I didn't forget to heal. I just couldn't link it up in time. Don't attack me. Oh, got another turn. Woo! Got another turn. Whew. Almost lost my cool. Very nearly lost my cool, which would have been bad. So, right, let's do the pinks almost first, just to make sure that we don't cock it up live in front of gazillions of people. 4 times combo, but we got the heal. That's the main thing. Jesus! Right, now we can use some abilities. Change some colours. I've got the ability that changes colours as we go. So let's, to an extent, I'm going to use them just to kind of level up everything, to heal myself up, to hopefully survive the next attack. Right, it might actually be better to use these guys on these guys, because as long as we get 5 times, it'll attack everything anyway. So if we start over here, go for some of them. Put that together. What have we got? Bibbidi bobbidi, bibbidi bobbidi, bibbidi bobbidi boo. Come on. Go on. Give me some skin. Yeah. Come on. Burn with me. That deserves a bit of Addy Gold. Don't you think? Bit of Addy Gold there for that one. Right. This is where we died last time, but we're not going to do that again. That ain't going to happen this time, because I'm going to use Clara's ability to level up that bit up. We're going to use Oswald's ability to chuck in some black gems afterwards. Then what are we going to do? Who's vulnerable to what? If we aim for this little dude first, we've got the black gems coming in, it'll hurt him more. I'm going to start with red gem right-hand side. Go down, go left, down. That gives me the blues, gives me the yellows. Come out around the side. Reds back through the blues. Think. It's a little bit dodgy, but then we actually, oh, it kind of extends the blue combo as well. Probably could have done something with the blues there as well, but that's enough. 4. There we go. There's the blacks. Come on, give me some sugar. Whoa. I like it. Right, now we'll go. Now we're cooking with mustard. Well, what does it taste like if you cook with mustard? Probably takes all the flavor out of it, which probably makes it not a pretty fairly stupid ingredient to cook with. Okay, now I'm going to start with this blue here. I'm going to come in and out of that one. I'm going to go up there, going to do those. I'm going to turn that into a 5. I'm going to come down there, do the blues. 4 times combo, maybe a 5 if I'm lucky. I was not lucky. Luck. Ow, and I took a bit of a whack. 40% enemy damage to enemies' current HP. Let's use that ability on there. Oh, it's all enemies' current HP. Okay, fair enough. Right, now let's do a wombo combo bombo. Do 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 do. That one. Double wham round there. Put some greens together, but I can't without making up another combo. No matter. 3, 4. Woo! Die! How is that thing still standing? How's he standing? Yeah. Uh-oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Once I caught a fish in heaven. Should probably tell that one first. There we go. Same difference, really. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then I let it go again. Well, why did you let it go? Because I missed the combo, so I got myself stuck on the bottom, but it took me long enough to weed around. But he should be dead anyway. He should be dead. Why is he not dead? Oh, this is going to be a good combo. This is going to be a good combo, because we're going to do that. Then 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 we're going to do that. Oh, I ran out of time. Oh, I've got that stinking ability on that stops the thing with the thing with the thing and it's taking a second off. I need to turn that one off. Because it's costing me combos, man. More waves? I don't want more waves. I just want your blood. We've got a bunch of greens. Let's use the greens. I'll turn it into reds. Could do. Yeah, why not? They're powered up. I've got loads of care red characters. So let's do this. Can't do this. We're going to do this and it's going to be good. Oh, I could have moved that one up and got a 5. Ah, hope that doesn't cost me. Boom! Aha! And you've just given me raw reds, you fool. You trinket fool. Right, where's a good place to start? Got black on the bottom left. There's some greens. There's some blacks to combo. There's the blues. You got me singing the blues. We need a red five-way somewhere. I think this is probably one of those ones not to overthink, because it's probably just going to be simpler to just match up these. Yeah, there's a line of four red fives there. It should be good. Six times combo. And we'll watch everything. Oh, how did he survive that? Really? Oh, and I'm poisoned.
No one poisons me.
And I've got myself stuck in a hole. And, oh, there we got a black combo out as well. Five, six, five. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. And all the people said, come on, hit me with your final wave. Hit me, hit me. Ow. Great, now I need to heal. Luckily, I've got Clara, who shall heal me most verily. Most verily, for I shall be healed. And my hands are all, like, ready to bounce. So ready to bounce. Right, we're going to start there. We're going to do that. We're going to do that. Undo that. We're going to do that. No, I've got myself in a pickle. Pickle! Ah! Got a four combo, haven't I? Whew, if that was the survival level, I'd nearly lost it. Right, now let's use... Give me my yellow gems back. Right, now we'll use his ability. 40% damage all over the place. There we go. A bit of a heal there as well. Nice to see. Thank you very much. Okay, so let's see what we can do with that. Black combo. That wasn't a good turn. I only got three. Should have thought it through. I rushed. Because I'm kind of feeling that I'm better, you know? So then I'm kind of like... You know, let's rush these things a little bit more, and then I do that, and I kind of cock it up. Right, so let's look where the combos are. We need a pink. We must heal this turn. In fact, let's heal up before the turn even begins by using a couple of abilities, and that should make the matching easier as well. Okay, so here's a little sneaky maneuver. Well, I'm sure a lot of you are aware of this one. But you see there. There you go. There's a pink gem there. If we move from the right-hand side of that one through that pink gem, it's going to move one to the right. And if that moves one to the right, then it's above the other pinks with the yellows in the way. And if I then move down through the yellows, that matches up the yellow. So the pink gem will then drop onto the other pinks and complete that one. So, I mean, I'm sure there'll be other ways around to do it, but especially when you've got time to think about it, you can just spot little kind of combos like that. So if I match up the pink gems on the left, on the far right-hand side first, bring something across, go through that pink gem and then down before I finish, then I'm guaranteed to get that little match as well, which is nice. So we'll go for something like that, through that gem like that, through that gem like that. Stop there. Everything else drops on top of everything else. We all get very excited about the fact that I'm still poisoned and I managed to get some heal. And they both go down! Through that doorway. We're going through the door. We are going through the door. Through the door we shall go. Good. Well, we have learned lots of new and exciting things today. We've fiddled with Jenny. We've completed an expert level first time, although I will accept that it was balanced for a different team. We have We have completed the beginning of chapter 4. We have tried to find my Twitter account. Let's hope nothing awkward comes up while I go on here. Going on to Twitter Live. Let's hope no one sent me anything dodgy. Although it's on Twitter, sure it shouldn't happen because in theory everyone can see it. But there's some strange exhibitionists around. Turns out I haven't updated this for a while. 21 notifications. What have we got? What have we got? What have we got? We've got... Snapchat from Porcelina. Small Blue Blunky saying, I never liked white chocolate. Cyber Addyception. I don't understand. Cyber Addy. That's not Cyber Addy. I can do better Cyber Addy than that. It's black and white. I'll give you that. He paused me with a really goofy expression as well.
I've been playing Legacy. And I've just smashed up a combo.
God, it's my phone. It's mine. Anything like that? Lots of people talking about white chocolate. Where are these court playing Legacy things? Lots of people saying thank you for the Tom Baker costume, which is awesome. Right, I guess I need to search for the hashtag, don't I? Yeah. And then you can embarrassingly see there that my last two searches were actually meant to be tweets. I just put it in the wrong box. Oscar noms. Oscar noms. Great. Is that the top things? So, what is it? Court playing doctor. Bam. Aha! Somebody got caught playing doctor. Oh, that's cool. That's a great facial expression. You indeed, you were caught, sir. You were caught. Oh, no. He's been caught playing Legacy. Oh, and that's some of the, bigger on the inside stuff, I think. Two so far. It'll be cool to see more of them. Right. Awesome. Great. Smashing. Super. Spiffing. Hooray. Good things. Good times. I don't know why I'm doing this. I haven't really thought about it. So, we'll go to commercial and the stream might end or it might carry on. I don't know. I'm going to drink this, eat the last piece of chocolate and ponder intellectual thoughts. Thanks for coming anyway. It's been fun. You've been fantastic. And you know what? So was my thigh.